G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. We haven't had a look at a 135 scale resin figure for a little while, so I thought we could take a look at this one from Mantius Miniatures, World War II German Grenadier. This one's pretty good if you don't like painting too much flesh. You've only got just the face to paint there, and then obviously the rest is just in the coat and the boots, so it's pretty simple when it comes to flesh tones. So let's take a look inside. So here are all the parts laid out. Now I did get two heads in mine. I'm not sure if that's the case or not. It doesn't say anything about two heads on the box or anything like that. I'm not sure if that was an accident or you do get two heads. And I'll show you soon, but the heads look exactly the same. So that's why I'm not sure if you're supposed to get two heads in it or not, or whether it's just been by accident that I've picked up two heads. We'll take a look at the body first. The casting's done pretty well. There is a little bit of a casting line from this boot here. You can see the flash there and it sort of goes up the side there. But it's not too bad actually, and it almost sort of disappears when it comes up to the above his belt there. And then when I turn over and go around the other side, it might show up on camera, but I can hardly actually see anything on the other side there. The actual overall sculpting I think is nice. The only thing I'd say is, and I am being picky here, but with the buttons, and this may be the case with the actual real coat, but I find that the buttons up the top here are probably a little bit more like a bit of a flat button with a sort of like a pebbly type sort of flatness to it. And I find these two lower ones here, and as I say, it could be the case with the actual real coat, they're probably like, they look a little bit more like balls that are just sort of hanging off the coat rather than top buttons. So someone can chime in there and let me know if that's the case with the real coat. I'm only highlighting that just because obviously I'm doing the review, and I just did notice quite a bit of a difference between these sort of buttons here and the top ones. Other than that, if I was to be really picky, just with the MO pouches down here where they come down underneath, they kind of look like they're sort of, even though they do come down underneath, they sort of look like they sort of come out a bit and are touching the coat, which I kind of think even just looks a little bit unusual if I was to be very picky. But other than that, as I was saying, it's a pretty simple painting process to some degree. He's got gloves on, so there's no flesh there, and the boots and the trousers and the coat, so pretty easily to paint this little fella. And on the back here as well, you can see he's got his bread bag attached, and hopefully it'll show up. The buckles are done reasonably well on his coat as well. So I think the actual body's done nicely. And I also think it's a bit of a different stance. You don't sort of see this stance every day with him sort of, you know, legs sort of semi-spread apart, holding his rifle. And it's a believable pose, and I just don't think you see it every day, so that's why I sort of picked it up. The casting on the glove, you've got the lines going down the gloves. Some of it's probably not as tidy as what it could be. There's a little bit of bumps there, or something that probably shouldn't be there. But, you know, as again, I'm being pretty picky. I'm used to sort of Alpine miniatures and Evolution miniatures, which I think are probably the top of the range in these sort of figures at the moment. But I'd say this is pretty close to it. So yeah, pretty impressed by this one. Might just take a quick look at the two heads. So it might show up better on camera, but I can't see too much of a difference in these two faces. So I'm kind of thinking that maybe it was a mistake that I got two heads, which I'm not complaining about, of course, but hopefully someone doesn't miss out on a head if that's the case. Or maybe they're just trying to match Alpine miniatures by giving two heads. Even if they are the same, or maybe they're different and I'm just not picking it up. But the actual faces are done very nicely. The only real issue I have with this is, and I've said it a fair few times, I'm not a fan of, and it is a reasonably sized casting block on the helmet there. I wouldn't say it's a tiny one. And I'm probably just not a fan of this method anymore of attaching things. I would have much preferred if it was on the neck, or, you know, do it the way Alpine miniatures and Evolution miniatures do it, which is not this way normally these days. There is and you do get a bit of a casting line down the back here. It's nothing tragic, pretty easy to clean up that part, but I'm just not a big fan of, on a you know, look at the size of that. I'm not a big fan of that. And I know it's minor, but when you don't have to do this anymore, I don't think why you need to. If the other companies aren't doing this way anymore, I think it'd be easier just to put it on the neck, or, I don't know, check out Alpine Miniatures figures and you'll know what I'm talking about. Some of my reviews I've done. Just give you a side profile of the helmets there, and hopefully it'll show up there. You can sort of see which I don't see too often sometimes, is you've got the hair coming down the back behind the helmet as well. And it's quite fine. It might not show up, but that's actually done quite realistically as well. Again, other than the probably the casting block on the back and the little seam line, I think these are done quite well. So here's the rest of the equipment here. And it was quite funny at the start. I was looking in the box for the rifle, and I thought they hadn't given it to me until I realized they've actually broken it in half, just to sort of go through from there to there. And they've sort of just connected into two pieces. I'm actually pretty impressed. They've got some very crisp detail on the buckles on the knife and spade, and on the water bottle and the mess tin as well. All of these are done really well. I'm really impressed. And the rifle's not done bad either. So when it comes to the actual equipment, I think they've done a really good job on it. On the back here, you can sort of see with a couple of parts, they've got some little knobs there that attach into the back of the figure here and here, and they fit in there quite nicely. The water bottle's got a little bit of an indentation there for the water bottle to sit in, and it looks quite realistic when it's placed in there. Sorry guys, it probably is a little bit blurry. So all up, just pulling this figure out of the box and taking a look at it, can compare it to obviously a lot of the other figures that I've reviewed on. I'd say I'm more than happy with this figure. I'd probably give it maybe about, I'm being picky, but I'll give it about an 8 out of 10. The only things I think bring it back is the casting line, the big block probably on the helmet there, and possibly just the minor things that I've mentioned on the uniform previously. But other than that, I think 99% of people, if they pull this out of the box, they'll be more than happy with it. And the best thing about these figures now, which is great that manufacturers are doing it, that they've left this open. So if you want to actually put a different head on it, you've got an extra alpine head or whatever that you want to whack in there, or who knows, a hornet head, they've made it easy for you to be able to do that. So much appreciated there. Another quick little 135 scale resin figure review from me. And just be careful, because I don't want to steer people in the wrong direction. I'm not actually sure if you do get two heads in the kit or not. So just be mindful of that, because I don't want to lead anyone astray. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.